The well-renowned author Scott Peck, in his world-famous book, The Road Less Traveled, makes a statement: problems are the cutting edge that distinguishes between success and failure. They call forth wisdom and courage. In fact, they make our wisdom and our courage. Problems always lead us to maturity, both mentally and spiritually. Later, Benjamin Franklin would say, "All that hurt also instruct." My brothers and sisters, and my beloved confreres, a very hearty welcome to the first Sunday of Lent. A time to be alone, a time to retrospect, renew, and recreate. We travel with Mark the Evangelist, once again discovering the wisdom of the Gospel. One of the specialities of Mark the Evangelist is the use of one word very recurringly in his Gospel, the word immediately. In fact, Mark the Evangelist uses this word immediately in Greek, pronounced as euthus, 42 times. All the other three evangelists together do not use this word so many times as Mark does. For Mark, the action-packed lifestyle, the involved ministry of Jesus is more important than the verbal teachings that he communicates. Therefore, the urgency to follow the word of God is very strongly highlighted by Mark the Evangelist. And that's exactly the way he begins the gospel of the day. The Spirit immediately drove Jesus to the desert. We are encountering today the gospel passage which depicts the temptation of Jesus in the desert. The Spirit immediately drove him. The Spirit pushed him, in fact. That means Jesus was captured by the power of the Spirit. In contrast to the writings of other evangelists, Luke and Matthew, who in fact narrate all the three temptations of Jesus in the desert, Mark does not speak at all about any particular temptation. Instead, he says he was there in the desert 40 days. For Mark, all the 40 days of Jesus' stay in the desert were days of temptation. This refers back to the life experience of the Israelites themselves. The people of Israel wandered through the desert 40 years long. And you know very well, all these 40 years of their journey were years of temptations for them. Elijah and Moses fasted and prayed in the desert 40 days. And these 40 days are times of preparation for a person to rediscover his own personality and the power that is inside of him. That's why we always notice when there is an opposite power, there is also an encouraging power. The name Satan means the adversary, the one who opposes all that is positive. But the Spirit is the advocate, the one who supports all that is necessary. This is what exactly the name Israel means. Ish means man or human being. Ra is evil. El is God. Between the human being and God, there is this evil. The temptation is to remain with the evil. But the El, the Lord, forces man to look into the possibility of his life, remove the evil that is between God and human being, and thus merge with each other. This time of the temptation of Jesus in the desert is a clear view and perspective for each one of us, my brothers and sisters, to rediscover the possibility of reuniting ourselves in spite of the litmus test of temptation that we are facing against the character that we possess. Every temptation is a test against your character. Who you really are, you prove through the way you encounter a life situation. Adam was in the Garden of Eden, in the most conducive place where he had been in favor with God. But the moment he fell in temptation, he destroyed the relationship and went away from God. But Jesus, in the most contrasting situation and the most difficult moment of his life, now stands for God, fighting against the evil spirit. One of the most important aspects of Jesus' experience of these temptations in the desert is that this is the only time during the public ministry of Jesus after his baptism that he is without human nearness. No human being is near him. He cannot communicate his struggle to anyone. He is alone. The presence of the wild animals around him shows the intensity of his struggles. Before the fall, Adam was also with various kinds of animals, wild and mild. He was never affected. But the moment he fell into temptation and destroyed the relationship with God, he went away from the true experience of relationship. The wild animals are symbols of negativity, struggles, and distance from God. My brothers and sisters, that's precisely the reason in the second reading today, Saint Peter telling us, have a pure conscience. There were 8 persons in the ark which Noah constructed, and they were saved through water that resembles the water of the baptism. Baptism is not to remove the external dirt. It is to create a pure conscience inside of us. And only those who have pure conscience can encounter God in the most intimate way. That's why the first reading today from the book of Genesis would teach us that we need to encounter God in the most interior covenant that He has built for us. A covenant that is unconditional. A covenant that is universal for all of us. Yes, my brothers and sisters, let this season of Lent be a time for us to evaluate how we really live our life. Shall we take a time alone in the desert experience of our lives, fighting against the adversary, together with the advocate who strengthens and illumines our life? Let's remember the words of Scott Peck. Problems are cutting edge that distinguishes between success and failure. Amen.